Bonjour. Aujourd'hui, nous allons parler du présent de l'indicatif des verbes réguliers. So, as usual, please take your pen and be ready to ask questions at the end if you have any. Okay, so, what do we use it for? Let's have a look at these sentences to start with. Tous les jours, je mange une pomme pour rester en forme. En ce moment, j'étudie le présent de l'indicatif. And le soleil se lève tous les matins. Have a look and have a think about it for a few seconds. Which one is a general truth? Which one is an action that is taking place as we speak, and which one is a habit? Okay, as you can see, number one is definitely a habit. The first thing you see is I'm using a connective like tous les jours, so it's a repeated action in the present, something I do all the time. It's a habit. Number two, en ce moment, j'étudie le présent de l'indicatif. Again, the connective I'm using at the moment, I am studying, okay? So that's a action that is taking place as we speak, and we would be using a present continuous in English, I am studying, okay, to show that this action is taking place now. And finally, le soleil se lève tous les matins, we hope that it's going to happen every morning, and it's a general truth, okay? So as you can see, there's a big difference between French and English here, in the fact that we only have one present tense, you have two, okay? I study, I am studying, I eat, I am eating. Whether you want to say I eat, I am eating, you will always say je mange, okay? So let's make sure that we understand that. Okay, so how do we form it? As you know, we have three groups of verbs in French. Okay, that's where it gets a little bit difficult for the present tense. The first one are the ER verbs, the second, the IR verbs, and the last one, the RE verb, the third group. To form the present tense, we need to remove those endings. So the first thing we're going to do is remove the ER, the IR, and the RE. Okay, so far so good. So we're left with three stems for regular verbs. And then we just add the ending. So for ER verbs, I'm going to, because I've got an ER, that can give you a clue about the verb ending I'm going to use. I'm going to keep the E, okay? So E, ES, E, O, N, S, E, Z, E, N, T. For IR verbs, we're going to have IS, IS, IT, ONS, EZ, and ENT. And for RE verbs, S, S, nothing, or T sometimes, ONS, EZ, and ENT. Okay? So you can see that there is a little pattern here. ER verbs keep the E somewhere, IR verbs keep the I. The RE verbs are a little bit more tricky. Now, if we look at the plural forms of those verbs, though, there is a good news there, is that they use the same verb endings. It's ONS, EZ, ENT, whatever group we're looking at. So that's good news. We don't have to work too hard on this. It's just the singular forms that we need to know. Now, there's no secret. You have to practice. You have to learn this in order to control it. Okay, so I'm afraid you'll just have to practice. So, a couple of things that I need to tell you, though. As you know, in French, we have a lot of silent letters. So, please do not pronounce those S's and T's at the end, okay? Tu travailles is not tu travailles. Tu finis is not tu finis. I don't want to hear them. Tu finis, tu travailles, tu attends, okay? We don't hear those letters at the end. Again, for the ils and elles form of the verbs, the ENT is pronounced E. Ils travaillent, ils finissent, ils attendent. Okay, so we're not hearing that ENT. Don't say ils travaillant, ils finissant, ils attendant, which is often what we hear. Ils attendent, ils finissent, ils travaillent. Okay. So let's practice a little bit. Put the verbs in brackets in the correct form of the present tense. And pause now, and you'll have the correction coming afterwards. Okay, so take your time, do this in your book, and make sure you do it correctly. Pause now. Here is the correction. Je regarde la télé et je finis des BD. Nous mangeons des biscottes et écoutons la radio. Tu télécharges des CD et envoies des emails. On attend le bus. On choisit un cadeau pour notre ami. Ils finissent leurs devoirs trop tard. Quand elle entend cette musique, elle commence à danser. L'école primaire commence à 9h et finit à 15h. Vous réussissez aux examens. Tu réfléchis au problème. Okay, so you just have to apply the rules when you come to regular verbs in the present tense in French. Now, as I said, it is quite tricky, even though it looks quite simple. So I've put here quite a few links to other websites that you could use to practice. Okay, they're all kind of online exercises. Finally, as far as the present tense of irregular verbs are concerned, they do not by definition follow a pattern, so you need to learn them independently. This link here has a list of all the irregular verbs in the French language and their pronunciation. They've put them into order of frequency, which is really good. So the most frequent ones will be the first ones on the list. I strongly advise you to visit that website and just listen to these verb endings from time to time. Well, I hope you found this video useful. And again, if there's anything that still is tricky to you, or you're wondering how to solve a problem, please ask your teacher to help you. Au revoir.